Hey guys, Pitmaster. I'm here with Vato, and we happen to teach kids self-defense. That's our life, right? And self-defense, kids and adults, that's our passion. Right now, we're gonna talk about kids. We're gonna talk about kids and self-defense. Bullying is huge.
Bad.
Right. Parents want to spend so much time and energy teaching their kids to swim. And I was like, why are you spending so much time teaching a kid to swim? Well, they might drown. What, like 14 kids a year drown? Who drowns? And you gotta take your kid to the pool, right, and watch them drown? You're gonna be right there.
Take them there, Jake. You put them.
You're gonna put him in the pool, and then he's gonna drown? How do kids drown? Why do they spend so much time teaching kids how to swim? But guess what? Over 5 million kids a year get seriously bullied to the point where they don't want to go to school, they become very depressed and withdrawn, and they become suicidal. A lot of kids every year commit suicide because of bullying. So bullying is a huge problem. It's a huge problem. And you have to take it seriously. And one of the biggest problems with bullying right now is the way the school reacts to it and treats it.
No tolerance.
Okay. No, there's zero tolerance. They have zero tolerance for defending yourself against the bully.
Yeah.
They have zero, they will suspend you. They will expel you if you beat someone up that's bullying you. So it's ingrained in the kids now. They're so scared. First they're scared of the bully, and now they're scared of the school if they defend themselves.
Get in trouble.
They're so scared of getting in trouble.
I mean, I don't want kids to get in trouble, but man, you can't let
bully you,
man. Put hands on you, that's not good.
It's not good, and I'll tell you what, parents out there, we're not gonna change the schools. The schools are run by the people the schools are run by. And they're looking out for themselves and their liability. There's zero tolerance for defending yourself. I say as a parent, you as a parent should have zero tolerance
for bullies.
For bullies. For anyone bullying your child, whether that's verbally or physically. We're focusing on physically. I'm not really into the whole social media bullying, or, you know, I'm into reality, like they're right there in front of you, not the keyboard stuff. Even though that can be hurtful, right?
That leads to, you know, bad things too.
That could lead to bad things, but to me, that's not gonna happen if the kid has confidence and the person is scared of what'll happen to them if they write stuff about them. Your kid should be that kid that nobody is gonna pick on. Physically, verbally, or on social media. That kid be confident. And the best way to build a kid's confidence is teach them how to fight. They want kids to learn how to swim, and they learn how to do draw, and they learn how to baseball and kick a soccer ball. And teach your kid how to defend himself. Every child and adult should learn. It boggles my mind when I see an adult, especially a male, hitting like this when they first get here. It's like, no, they know how to throw a ball, they're not a baseball player, right? They know how to kick a ball, they're not a soccer player, but all kids know how to shoot a basket. It might not go in, but they know how to do it. Why doesn't every kid know how to do the most basic, innate skill that we have as humans? We have two main skills as humans to stay alive. Flight, which means run, or fight, which means defend yourself. Everyone knows how to run. Now everybody should learn how to fight to defend themselves.
They have to.
They should never be a bully and never pick on anyone, and you teach them that. We teach them that here at the Pit. Never be a bully. But never be bullied. And it's better to be suspended than comatose because you let some kid pick on you and he slammed you down on the concrete. Or even worse, it's better to be suspended than find your kid hanging someday because he's so depressed because he's being bullied and he doesn't know how to stop it. Right? So as his parents, His teacher, his school administration, they are not gonna help him. They're not looking out for him or her. You have to, as his parent or her parent.
Do you think a lot of parents talk to their kids about like bullying and what they should do?
I think a lot of parents do, and I think a lot of parents say, never throw the first punch.
Never throw the first punch.
You always have to throw the first punch.
Think about
because
it.
If he does,
you're gonna get
hit. You're gonna get hit, fall on the ground.
Get knocked out. You're gonna end up in a
nursing home.
Getting turned every
4 hours by a Filipino nurse.
Not good.
Not good at all. Never tell your kid, don't ever throw the first punch. They have to throw the first punch. Never out of anger. Never as a challenge. Right? So they never throw a punch out of anger from words. Never as a challenge, like let's fight and then fight. No, never. But if they feel threatened and that person is close enough to hit them and they feel he is gonna hit them, they need to hit first. And guess what? If that person wasn't gonna hit them, they shouldn't be in their face yelling at them in the first place. Because your kid isn't doing that. Your kid's not the bully. All right, so if a bully gets knocked out and gets hurt and gets hit, okay, that's the least of our worries. The most of our worries is you good kids out there, your good kids are getting bullied. And the kids are gonna hate school, they're gonna get depressed, they're gonna kill themselves. And they're gonna grow up and be bully targets. So teach your kids confidence. Teach your kids how to fight. Take them somewhere where they can learn self-defense. You don't mind, you take them to the pool, that's really cool, right? All the moms take them to the pool. Yeah, they're swimming, and then, guess what? Like I said, about 14 kids a year drown. About 14 kids a year. I'm exaggerating a little, but drowning is nowhere near the epidemic that being bullied is. So, take care of your kid. Pay attention to him. Teach him how to fight, or her. Teach him how to defend himself, and let him know you can throw the first punch. And guess what? Tell your kid, if you get suspended because you defended yourself, I'll take you out for ice cream and I'll buy you a present. All right? Be a good parent and do that, all right?
Teach your kids about bullying.
Teach them. Thanks for coming.